Thank you for watching my video. My name is Mr. Charles Winnicke. In this video tutorial, we will continue from where we stopped. In the other previous video, we will discuss on polarized capacitor, and I gave you the brief example of it, which I explained a little bit on that. I use this diagram to explain the difference between polarized and non-polarized capacitor, which in this present video right now, I am going to treat on non-polarized capacitor, which I remember what I told you on the previous video. I told you that non-polarized capacitor, it can work in AC or in DC operation, while polarized capacitor can be worked on only in DC capacitor. And non-polarized capacitor, it has a lower capacitance, which is boldly here. And I also use this diagram as well to explain how non-polarized capacitor, how it look like. This is how the non-polarized capacitor, the diagram, how it look like. So we will discuss it more. Non-polarized capacitor is what we are about to discuss, and that is what we are discussing right now. So in that case, under non-polarized capacitor, it has thin capacitors and it has a ceramic capacitor. There are other ones as well that I have not disclosed to you, which when I will treat it on its own, definitely I will discuss it, each and every one of them. So let's go straight to the main thing right now. So in that case, non-polarized capacitors types are capacitors that can have voltages of either polarity across them. What I mean by voltages either at polarity across them is they can take in current or voltage from the left or from the right. They don't have a polarity, so there is no polarity effect that will affect them. So in that case, you can as well fix it either which way at all. So that is what I am trying to explain here. So non-polarized capacitor types are capacitors that can have voltages of either polarity across them. You can fix it whichever way that pleases you. That is what I mean in this area. And non-polarized capacitors of this type, have no positive and no negative terminal. It means it does not have plus and minus, and can be mounted in both ways, just as I explained before, and it can be mounted in both ways in electronics board or electronics motherboard. If you remember when I discussed on polarized capacitor, it has plus and minus, and it must be mounted accurately or correctly. But in this case, in this non-polarized capacitor, you can mount it in both ways without minding anything, because it accepts the current or voltage from both sides. That is just the difference between the non-polarized and polarized capacitor. Also, remember that in non-polarized capacitor, the capacitance are very low, while in terms of polarized capacitor, the capacitance are very high. And a non-polarized capacitor, it can work in AC as well as in DC, while in polarized capacitor, it can only work in DC. Common non-polarized capacitors are made up of ceramic, mica, or polypropylene. All these are examples of non-polarized capacitor. And when I will be discussing each and every one of them, one after the other, you will see how you will see their images or their picture, how they look like. You will see mica, you will see ceramic, you will also see polychronic capacitor. Polychronic the capacitor, and so on and so forth. We also have other capacitor that is under non-polarized that I haven't mentioned. So I will treat them specially in that area. Once I am to discuss or treat on that particular area. What I'm doing right now is to introduce you or to inform you that we have polarized and we also have non-polarized. When I will discuss on those and on each and every one of them, I might not have much time to explain this is because I will assume that you have already watched the previous videos that I have treated so far. So in that case, you should also take notes in case of necessity. The main characteristics for non-polarized capacitors is that they block DC and let AC pass. They block DC. DC, it simply means they block direct current and let alternating current to pass. Remember, I told you that non-polarized capacitor, it can be used in AC as well as in DC. Now, they are also able to store voltages for a short moment. They are also able to store voltages for a short moment. The dielectric in non-polarized capacitors is a solid material that makes the device durable and reliable, which means that the dielectric of non-polarized capacitor is different from dielectric of polarized capacitor. That is just the simple way to explain it. The polarized being the capacitor, being the dielectric material you use in polarized, and the one that you use in non-polarized are not the same. Both of them are in different area, but they are all called polarized and they are all called dielectric. But they are not meant to be used or they are not meant to be interchanged. Because remember that dielectric capacitor is determined by the dielectric we used. So that is just how it is. So in that case, dielectric in non-polarized capacitors is a solid material, and you know what solid means exactly. So that makes the device durable and reliable as well. And this is the picture or the finishing product or the image of non-polarized capacitor, and this is how it looks like. This one is called ceramic. All this one that you are seeing here is called ceramic. While this one is called nano capacitor. This one is called we also have a mica capacitor and so on and so forth. These are the image or the pictures of non-polarized capacitor. Typically, the different types of capacitors or capacitor are named after the type of dielectric they contain. This gives a good indication of the general properties they exhibit. What I'm trying to explain here, just I have already explained it before. The dielectric we determine the particular name of capacitor. Let's say you are to produce, in terms of non-polarized capacitor, you are to produce a mica capacitor. Definitely you will use a mica dielectric Because you cannot use a mica dielectric to produce a ceramic dielectric. It won't work. So the dielectric will determine the name of the capacitor. Thank you once again for watching my video. Please, if you like my video, subscribe to my channel, comment and like. See you in the next class.